When you think of summer music, you probably think about light pop hits like Bruno Mars that get stuck in your head.
But we have met one person who is spending his summer singing opera and making a living at it. We get to him in a moment, but first we find that golf can be fun even when it's a job. It's just past 9 a.m. on a weekday, mind you, and already balls are flying everywhere at Stone Meadow Golf. It's been a summer ritual at this Lexington driving range since 1993, when the Carroll family decided to repurpose this former farmland rather than see it developed. Now they've got 75 grass and synthetic hitting surfaces, putting greens galore, even a 9-hole par 3 course.
A lot of people like to come here because they don't have time for a round of golf. So they can get their golf in 45 minutes to an hour here versus going to a golf course where it's going to take 2 to 4 hours depending on how many holes you play.
400 to 600 golfers stream through Stone Meadow on a typical summer day. Their four teaching pros are busy morning till night. There are half-day golf schools for kids where they use such unorthodox techniques as hitting water balloons to hone rookie backswings.
The balloon is fun. The golf ball looks intimidating. It's 1.68 inches in diameter versus a balloon that's that big. So it's a lot more difficult to do, but it really isn't if they do the same thing over and over. So that's how we brought the balloons into the program.
I like to practice going in the hole.
Twice a week, Stone Meadow Golf offers free lessons to seniors. Out on the par 3 course, spry 86-year-old teacher Joseph DeVico stresses to his students that golf keeps you fit, mentally challenged, and socially engaged.
You're in heaven here. I sign in at 9 o'clock. I was here at 7, fixing ball marks, walking around. It's heaven on earth.
At any one time, Stone Meadow has 100,000 golf balls in circulation. They also rotate old truck wrecks they've salvaged to give golfers a target.
We had a van, we put the Yankees emblem on there when the Red Sox play the Yankees, and we move it around to different locations on the range, and people really enjoy hitting the van and hearing that sound off of the Yankees van. During the football season, we did a Jets van, so we had the Jets logo and a football on there, and that drew a good crowd.
At $7 for 50 balls or $14 for 120, it's a pretty cheap way to groove your swing or just get the frustration out after a rough commute home.
I take lessons here on occasion, and the gentleman, George, who is the instructor, is tremendous as well.
I'm playing tomorrow, so I come down here to loosen up a little bit, get these old bones going.
It's one of the best places in the world, yeah. It's nice people, nice place, nice everything. It's just a beautiful place.
If you ever see Marshall Richards pedaling through the North End, that means some glorious sounds of summer are sure to follow.
Che bella cosa, una giornata e sole.
Marshall calls himself the Boston Opera Guy. Year-round, this talented 32-year-old performs with orchestras and opera companies. But in summer, he takes his pipes to the streets.
Most of the people that come up and approach me and tell me how much they enjoyed it and that it moved them are people who haven't necessarily ever listened to opera or even classical music. And that's one of the most fulfilling things about this. That's my whole goal, is to kind of open up the horizons.
Ave Maria.
When Richard sings in the North End, he says, you've got to go with the classic Italian operas. But he's become skilled at German as well.
German is my favorite language to sing, so I really like all the German composers, Bach, Handel, Haydn, Mozart, but you know, most of the real, you know, classic Italian stuff, that's what people really want to hear.
When he was younger, it was heavy metal that Richards himself really wanted to hear. Then one day, by happenstance, he heard an opera, and it was a revelatory moment.
When I really started getting into this music, I realized that this music has all of that, but tenfold. And it's so much more delicate and complex, and that's what I really love about it. I love the intensity and the passion.
Richards dreams of making a name for himself one day on the opera world stage. He is studying now with a voice coach at Harvard's Office for the Arts. For many men, their opera voices don't fully season until their mid to late 30s.
The biggest part for me is that I get to practice while still doing a job, making some money. But personal development is a huge part of this for me, so that I can continue doing what I do in front of people and, you know, gauging their response. Grazie, grazie. Thank you.
Ah, oh, beautiful. And we mentioned that Marshall loves German opera, and this was really a breakout year for him, that performance in Berlin.
Right, interesting journey from born in Alabama, was a busker on the streets of New Orleans for a long time before he came to Boston to study opera. And he says his goal now is to win the hearts and minds of the classical music community, and I think he's well on his way to doing that. He's certainly winning the public as well.
He won me over. Up next, mom gets the supplies, she does the selling.